So far, we had assumed that there were no errors on the channel connecting Alice and Bob. This is not a very realistic assumption. In a practical setting, there will always be some errors. That is, Alice and Bob will hold different bit strings. Now, imagine that we would try to blindly follow the protocols that we described earlier for key distribution. We would first bound the mean entropy of Alice's string given the eavesdropper, and then we would do privacy amplification. What would happen then? Alice and Bob would hash two different strings and would very likely end up with two keys that are different. And in consequence, these keys would be completely useless for any practical purpose. How can we deal with this problem? The main idea is to perform error correction. To this end, Alice and Bob need to perform one additional step before privacy amplification. This step is called information reconciliation. In information reconciliation step, Alice and Bob will exchange error-correcting information to correct errors. We will, in the following, learn how to do information reconciliation. First of all, let's describe the communication scenario. Alice and Bob hold two strings that we denote XA and XB. XB, the string of Bob, equals XA plus a string of errors that we denote by S. Alice and Bob are connected by a classical authenticated channel. An information reconciliation protocol consists simply in the exchange of messages over this channel, such that Bob can recover XA, that is, the string of Alice. We denote by CA the string consisting of all the messages exchanged over the classical channel. Finally, Bob, with the help of XB and CA, will output XA hat, that is, an estimate of the string of Alice XA. Now, what are the goals of the information reconciliation step? They are twofold. First and most obvious, Alice and Bob want to ensure that after reconciliation, the strings XA and XA hat are epsilon correct. That is, that the probability that they are different is at most epsilon. And second, they want to minimize the length of the communications over the classical channel. The reason is, as we saw previously, that they reduce our bound on the minimum entropy. Again, it is very easy to achieve any of both goals independently. Why is this? Imagine that a reconciliation protocol consists of Alice sending her whole string to Bob over the classical channel. This is a great protocol if we only care about correctness. The strings will definitely be correct, but the leakage is maximal, and after reconciliation, we would not have any mean entropy left to do privacy amplification. On the other hand, imagine a reconciliation protocol that consists in Alice and Bob doing nothing. Then, for leakage purposes, the protocol is perfect. The leakage is zero, but the strings might not be correct for the desired epsilon. For more discussion regarding the trade-offs between epsilon and the leakage, please check the lecture notes and the reference provided. Okay, let us investigate a little bit the possibilities available to Alice and Bob for reconciliation. First, they have access to the classical authenticated channel, which is bidirectional. So, in full generality, a reconciliation protocol might consist in the exchange of messages in both directions. Perhaps Alice sends some information to Bob, Bob processes that information and sends the message back to Alice, and they keep exchanging messages until some predefined condition is met. We call such a protocol a two-way or an interactive protocol. However, much more simpler and in many circumstances good enough. The whole reconciliation might consist of a single message from Alice to Bob. We call these reconciliation protocols one-way. In these protocols, we can think of Alice's encoding her string XA into CA and sending it through the classical channel. Then Bob decodes XA using both CA and XB. In one-way reconciliation schemes, it is common to call Alice the encoder and Bob the decoder. In the following, I will detail one concrete one-way reconciliation scheme that is not optimal, but will give us some insights into how reconciliation protocols work.